Hey guys, this is Chase from Alta Labs. I want to give you a quick review of the advanced features available as you create your first SSID. To access the advanced feature list, you'll first need to log in to manage.alta.eq. Once your site loads, go ahead and click into the settings option here at the very top ribbon. And in the submenu that appears, click into Wi-Fi. And then we're going to go ahead and create a new SSID. Once you've decided on a name and a password strategy here using AltaPass, if you come down a little further on the screen, you'll see this section called Advanced Settings. If you click the Advanced Settings language, that'll go ahead and display an Advanced Settings menu. Very first, we have a default network VLAN. This is the default VLAN that gets tied to all wireless devices that are tied to this specific SSID. If you change this out of the native VLAN or one, for example, VLAN 100, then as the traffic passes through the access point, it will then be tagged with VLAN 100. Now, in the event that you're using AltaPass with our multi-password strategy up above, if you have a various password with a different VLAN other than the default network VLAN, this will override the default network VLAN. So, for example, if you had a VLAN figure in here of 200, but your default network VLAN was 100, and your devices were joined using this first password, all devices would then see or be tagged as VLAN 200. Right below that, we have some notes. This is generally just for you to be able to record different thoughts or ideas or whatever it is that you have regarding this policy, perhaps a description regarding this SSID and these policies that you've set below. This does not in any way change the configuration. Right below that, you'll see that we give you the ability to change the bands that are broadcast on this specific SSID. By default, we have both enabled, and that's what we would recommend generally. However, we know in some instances, based on device type or based on project type, that you'll need to change this so that you are only broadcasting 2 GHz or 5 GHz on the specific SSID. So for today's example, I'm going to leave this set as both. Down here a little bit further, you'll see this option called fast roaming. But by default, we have 802.11 V and K, which are additional roaming policies that run on the Alta Labs access points. Those are always on and cannot be disabled. However, the third roaming policy that we have in effect is 802.11 R, and we actually bring this forward into the user interface so that you can decide if you want to enable that or disable that on a specific SSID. By default, we have this disabled, and the reason for that is generally Wi-Fi devices that are 2015 or earlier do not like to see fast roaming enabled. And believe it or not, even current, some and very few current Wi-Fi chipsets still don't like to have fast roaming enabled. So by default, we leave this off. However, in order to maximize and optimize your roaming performance across multiple access points on a single project, we do recommend that you enable that wherever possible. Right below that, we have something called PMF or Protected Management Frames. You generally want to leave this disabled unless you know that you need PMF enabled or you are using devices that are looking for PMF. If you have this enabled and you're not sure what it's for, or you know your device, or you're not sure if your devices support this, then it will cause some unwanted behavior on the specific SSID. The next option is called BSS Transitions. This is typically a setting that's used for debugging purposes. We leave this on by default and would ask that you do the same unless you're working with our tech support team. And then we may have you disable this depending on some issues that you may or may not see. Right below that, we have our 2 gig and our 5 gig DTIM period. Right now, by default, these are set to 1 and 3, and we recommend you leave these where they are at for optimal performance. Essentially, the DTIM option here allows you to select how often you want your SSID to transmit broadcast and multicast frames, whether it's every beacon or every other beacon or so on. The larger these numbers, the more beacons it will take before broadcast or multicast frames are transmitted. Essentially, your wireless devices will take longer to wake up if there's an inbound request from your access points. So again, we recommend you leave these at 1 and 3. WPA3 is pretty self-explanatory. If you're familiar with that, it's a higher level of encryption than WPA2. By default, we have this disabled, but we know there are some projects that require WPA3, so we do give you the option to enable that. We do have a little tooltip here that you are not able to use our WPA3 with more than one of our AltaPass password configuration policies. For example, if you want to create multiple passwords that have different VLANs associated with them, different rate limits, different site schedule and filter policies, then you would not be able to use WPA3 at this time. That is an industry-wide restriction, but based on Wi-Fi Alliance and IEEE, their current expectations with WPA3. However, we are working diligently with those governing bodies to come up with a way that WPA3 can work with AltaPass beyond just the first password. A little further down, we provide you both the download rate and upload rate limits here. You can hard set these on specific values that we have kind of canned and in these menus. You can also come in and enter a custom value here, but that will be for both download and upload rate limiting. Right below that, we have the option called site schedule. Most manufacturers offer some sort of Wi-Fi scheduler. Ours is a little bit better, and I'll walk you through how ours is unique and a little bit more handy, convenient for you and your users. Right now, I'm going to go ahead and use a turn on policy, and this is going to be, for example, if I'm running a business and I want to have my Wi-Fi available to my team or my employees during business hours, I would come in and create a turn on policy from say 8 a.m. to 6:30 or 6 p.m. During this window, all traffic will be able to pass so long as another policy is not restricting it from passing. And then once you are either before these hours or after these hours, the SSIDs on the Alta Labs access points will continue to broadcast, which is a good thing if you have, you know, a building automation system or a home automation system, or you have cameras you're trying to monitor. And again, based on Alta password above, you actually are able to bypass the site schedule. But in the event that you have a password that's governed by this site schedule, they will be able to connect the SSID, but they will not be able to browse any websites or pass any data traffic. But we do give you, as a site administrator, the ability to turn this little option down here to on. And essentially what will happen is if somebody connects outside of this turn on window, they will again be able to connect, but they will have to request additional time from you as a site administrator before they're able to see any data flow. The same applies for a turn off schedule. For example, if I want to turn my schedule off during business hours for whatever reason, if somebody is here during business hours, they can have this set to on and request additional time. The option right below that is called power user. This is if you're familiar with Hotspot 2.0 or ADSEC features. This is a very limited customer segment, so generally we recommend that you leave this off unless you're looking for these features. If so, we recommend that you contact our support team and we can walk you through how to use this a little bit more. Up here in the top right, we have IGMP Proxy. This is disabled by default. The only reason that we would recommend currently that you enable this is if you have IPTV in your project that is using multicast frames. Otherwise, again, we recommend that you disable this. Right below that, we have our hide SSID function. This is pretty self-explanatory. The SSID name above that you would be creating, if you have this enabled, then is hidden, which then requires any wireless device that you want to join this specific policy or this SSID would have to know the exact name, and they'd have to enter it by hand on their wireless devices. By disabling that, you would be able to join this wireless network how you would typically. You'd be able to go into your SSIDs here and see all of your various options for broadcasting networks, and you'd be able to pick one from the list of broadcasting SSIDs. Right below this, you see this multi-VLAN. This is again an option for debugging purposes. We generally recommend that you leave this enabled. This is more for certain devices that have multiple VLANs in a project and do not like traversing multiple VLANs. So again, if you have questions about this, or you feel like you are seeing issues with multiple VLANs in your project, we would ask that you reach out to our support team as soon as possible. We already covered the DTIM period, MAC filtering. We have both an allow and a deny list option. If you want to be super restrictive and only have a handful of MAC addresses that are able to connect to and use this SSID, you can select the allow list and you can enter whatever MAC addresses that you would like to be able to allow. In the event that you want to have a generally open policy, but you know there's a few devices that need to be denied, you can then select a deny list here and enter those handful of devices that you would like to, of course, deny. Upload rate limit, we already talked about. And then finally, hotspot. Built into each Alta Labs access point is a hotspot feature. We give you the ability to, first of all, have one stored locally where you can upload your logo for your splash page. You can give your splash page a title. You can come in and populate your own terms of service, or we also give you some generic canned terms that you can come in, click this button, it'll populate, and then you can edit them. You can also change this title if you don't like terms of service, if you want to call it terms of use or agreement or whatever it is, you can go ahead and change that there. And then finally here, you'd enter your password that you want your users to use to join your hotspot. And then finally your landing or redirect page here. In the event that you have an external hotspot service, like a third-party hotspot service that you want Alta Labs to redirect out to, you can come up and select this external hotspot menu option, enter the redirect URL, any sort of authorization secret, as well as any sort of additional hostname or IP information here in these fields. I'm gonna go ahead and disable this for this final walkthrough here. We're going to now touch on this airtime efficiency. For those of you who are unaware of what airtime efficiency is, we recommend that you leave this exactly where it's at. However, if you're dealing with a large stadium type deployment or a concert venue where you're gonna see a high saturation of wireless devices, we recommend that you do make some adjustments here depending on how saturated your environment is and how many access points you're deploying. We'd recommend that you reach out to our support team for some guidance here if it's your first time deploying in a stadium type environment. But essentially what airtime efficiency does is it gives you the ability to limit the range of a single AP, but keep the performance as high as possible. It broadcasts the beacons or the management or control frames at a higher rate. And so only devices that are actually within range of those frames can hear them. It also adjusts the rate control on the AP to only use the rates at or above the setting that you see here on these ribbons or these sliders. That way, the nearby spectrum is efficiently and exclusively used for close by devices. And that's it for the introduction into the advanced feature set within a BSSID. We appreciate you taking the time to watch this video. If you have any further questions regarding this video, please visit forum.alta.inc. Also, if there's any other requests for videos that you'd like to see us publish, please come over to forum.alta.inc and share your thoughts on future videos. Thank you.